Hi guys, welcome back to the Nik Collection series. Today we're going to talk about Silver Efex. I've been using it for near enough 15 years and I haven't seen another application that comes close. So what we're going to do today is to look at the way that Silver Efex can be integrated into your work stream, whether you're using Lightroom, whether you're using PhotoLab, or whether you're using Photoshop. Let's get into it. So here we are in Lightroom, and we've got a picture of a church. A couple of problems that we'll need to sort out. It's a hermitage, actually, it's not a church. But the other problem is the old converging verticals thing. So in order to get the cross in and give it some headroom, I had to tilt the camera slightly back. And if you look at the sides here, you'll see that they're converging. So the first thing we need to do is some very basic level one corrections in Lightroom. So get this to work. So just increase the exposure a little bit. We've got plenty of headroom. Actually, we are clipping ever so slightly on the left here. I'll just raise those shadows a bit. I'd like to see the wood in the door a little bit clearer, and that's probably enough. That'll do it, that'll give us something to play with. Now, the thing to quickly say here is that this is an absolutely perfect weather conditions for a black and white conversion. There's no amount of tinkering around with this colour photograph is going to make this compelling. There's no real story to tell here, but it would make a nice black and white photo. And partially that's because of the weather conditions. So the soft light filtered through these clouds is actually ideal for this kind of photography. So let's quickly correct those verticals. And we can do this in Lightroom. This is a very simple correction. Okay, so we come down here, we're doing it upright, we go to vertical transform and we rotate it until we think those verticals are more or less pointing straight up. Okay, and I think that's probably as good as it's going to get. we need to straighten it up slightly as well, which I probably should have done first, but let's do that now. Okay, I think that's, just check that. And we'll take that and we'll just bring this crop in to avoid the corners that we've lost through rotating. Okay, perfect. Okay, so from here we go to Photo, Edit In, and you do this from Photoshop as well, but there's no need to go into Photoshop with this, with Silver Efex. We're going to edit a copy with the Lightroom adjustments, so it's going to make a TIFF file. Okay, a little warning about working with TIFF files. It's not not so much a warning as a confirmation that you can come back to this and re-edit it, so not a warning at all. And we'll click on that. So the first thing to point out, we'll have a quick tour around the interface. On the left, you've got your presets, and there's a lot of them. There's 64 that come with the package, so out of the box you've got 64. You can import presets, you can save your own presets, and so on. They're split into classic, modern, vintage, en vogue, and so-called 25th anniversary presets. There are some that I definitely favour, so you can apply any of these. And the thing to point out here, I'm going to apply high structure, okay, because I like the high structure presets. The thing to point out here is that all of these presets are built effectively out of the controls that you've got here. There's no magic going on other than that. So you've got your loop here, you've got your histogram, you've got the Ansel Adams like zone system. So you can see as you move the cursor across the zones, you can see what you're going to be highlighting and affecting with these zones. So you can choose the zone that you want to alter. And this splits out into red, green, and blue channels. You've got global adjustments here, so brightness. So you can do global brightness, highlights, midtones, shadows, and dynamic brightness. Let's just demonstrate what that looks like. Okay, so that's it's effectively increasing the brightness and compensating within the midtones as well. So it would take that back to where it was. You can double click on the slider to return it to zero. You've got contrast adjustments, and the preset that we've chosen has set the amplify whites and the amplify blacks. Again, you can alter these to taste. That was on 25. You've got structural adjustments to bring out more detail in the picture. This is very clear, the difference between high structure and smooth structure, harsh high structure, yeah. Midtones have been adjusted. You can adjust these to taste. Tonality protection, so you might want to protect your shadows or protect your highlights from being altered by any of the other adjustments. And you've got selective adjustments here. Now the control points in Silver Efex Pro do not act as a, you know, to focus the effect of the filter. These act like normal control points. So if I were to place one here, you can see immediately that this is not, you know, I'm not just going to get black and white in the area of the control point. This is a global black and white conversion, and here I'm using a control point in exactly the same way that I would use it in PhotoLab, for example. So I can alter the scope of this. Bring that in, take it out, focus it around that little notice, maybe make that a little bit brighter. And you've got luminance, chrominance, and diffusion here, then brightness, contrast, structure, amplify whites, amplify blacks. It's effectively exactly the same controls as you've got here. And you'll see if you use these sliders, you'll see this reflected in the controls on the right. So just to demonstrate that, okay, I'm moving the amplify whites and you can see it move in the control panel over here. You've got selective tones, highlights, midtones, shadows and blacks, Clearview. My usual reservations about Clearview are very much in force here. I never use this more than 15-20% at absolute most, and that's the reason why. I think it looks rather better in Silver Efex, I must admit, than it does in PhotoLab, but I'm still reluctant to go with Clearview because I feel that it's doing sharpening and contrast, and I like to be able to separate these things. You've got colour filters here that mimic the effect of putting a colour filter over a lens. So these don't apply red so much as they affect the tones that you're getting from your black and white. So I can move that and you can see the effect on the tones. Take that back to default. You can choose from film types. You've got an absolute host of film types, and these are These are great. These are really good film emulations, and this is DxO doing what it's really good at. So you choose any of these, you'll get a different set of settings to alter. I'll keep this on neutral for the time being. You can change the grain, whether it's soft grain, hard grain, change the sensitivity of the filters here. You've got levels and curves, which work in exactly the same way as the traditional, you know, the levels and curves that you'll see in PhotoLab. And finishing adjustments, so toning, you can, these are effectively two-tone or one-tone filters. You can put a tone over the photo. Selenium is quite a nice sort of blue-tinged filter. You've got a more clearly blue-tinged filter here. Coffee. I tend to use, if I'm going to use anything to warm it up, I'll probably use the coffee filter. It's the most natural-looking one. You can apply vignettes here, and again, you get instant preview. You can burn the edges to emulate old-fashioned film production. And you can apply borders here. So if we do a type 9, type 8, type 7, and again, this is, you know, some people might find this a little bit gimmicky. I think it has its place, particularly around social media, but these emulate the look and feel of a photograph that's been pasted into a sort of Victorian photo album. And some of these are just clean, clear settings that you might use to frame a photo with. Okay, and the controls down here, size, spread, roughness, vary border, apply to the preset that you've chosen from the image borders, so you can clean these up as well. And when you've done all of this, you can save it as a fresh preset, and that will then come in under the custom presets. Okay, so that's pretty much Silver Efex Pro. You can access this from PhotoLab, you can access it as a standalone application, you can access it from Photoshop, Affinity Photo. So what I'm going to do is apply this to my photograph. Here we are in Lightroom. We need to turn the auto off there. And there we have the picture in black and white. Fantastic. Okay, one thing that remains is, I mentioned earlier that the TIFF thing enables you to edit the picture again. What I'm going to do is I'll just very quickly go into Photoshop to show you that in action, as it were. So this time I'm going to go to edit in Adobe Photoshop. And our palette automatically appears here. And what you will see when I open this in Silver Efex is it will create a copy of the background, and then it will create a smart object for Silver Efex. So here we go. And there's the filter. So if I just, I'll just very quickly choose a couple of bits here. We'll go for the same high structure. We will just, let's put that border on it so we can put a little bit of burn there. I think we did type 6. And I'll just make those a bit smaller. Okay, so I can click convert to smart object here, and I can apply it, and we will go back into Photoshop, and here we are. So in Photoshop, all of this information is preserved in the original Photoshop file. So I can come back in here, I can use other filters from other parts of the Nik application, and they will be stacked up here. But I can go back into Silver Efex. Okay. And I get the information plugins identified the active layer as a smart object and will now operate as a smart filter. Okay, so the brush is deactivated and the effect is applied to the current layer in Photoshop. All right, so that tells you, I'll cancel out of there. Close without saving. So this shows you the round tripping, basically, that takes place from Nik Collection and Photoshop. And in Silver Efex, this isn't essential, because Silver Efex is effectively a filter that you put on top of the photograph. But when you start to stack up, say, for example, Color Efex and Viveza, you will stack up filters here, and you're able to come back and you're able to change the opacity of each layer, and you're able to go back into the original application, into the Nik application, and alter the makeup of that thing. So working this way with Photoshop gives you a whole extra layer of flexibility that is very, very useful when you get into the sort of level 3 advanced processing. We can simply file save here, and that will go back into Lightroom. And same business, we take off the auto filter, and there it is. Okay, that's pretty much it for Silver Efex. Thanks very much for watching, guys. Give us a like, or even subscribe if you're not already subscribing. That would be fantastic. And next week we're going to be having a look at what I was just talking about, which is stacking up different filters, starting with Color Efex, moving into Viveza, and so on. So hopefully we'll see you next week. Thanks a lot.